Okay, it's February 5th, 2013. It's 2:20 p.m. Central Time. I did that little quarter piece right there, right in there, all with just this bow rake. It's not easy, but it's really like almost, you know, I don't want to say like the pioneers did that. I'm sure they worked harder than that. But I'm breaking up half of this, at least. I'm going to try getting that far part. I'm going to let this video for just a couple minutes and then come back over here and turn off the pause the video. This year, hopefully the garden will work. I'm going to dedicate this to my mother who passed away on December 28, 2012, at 3:49 p.m. Last year we did a garden across the road over there and by that yellow house. 3 days after it was planted, they told us that the guy had sold the land in the house and offered us this place over here. So I had at least I had 16 stalks of corn planted from Heirloom Seeds, no Monsanto or any of the other crap out of store. And the downside is all the fields around here are farmed with Monsanto corn. So I cannot grow any more corn. Since last year I had a few stalks here and all kinds of challenges popped up and I let the garden go to waste. That was really bad and pathetic and wrong on my part perhaps, but I didn't care for the garden like I will this year. So that's what I'm doing with this bow rake. I've done just over a quarter of the garden and a little bit I just worked right now. So you can see the darkest part on the left there is what I've just been doing. I'm gonna go all the way back so it's even right here across. It's 2:23 p.m. I'm gonna pause this. Okay, it's 2:28 p.m. I just did a little bit more over here. I did this last year with a tiller about 3 or 4 times, not as much as I should have. But now after Mom passed away, well, the brother's got the damn thing over at his house and tell me it's too early to be doing this. Yeah, he's Mr. Farmer John. Never too early to prepare your garden, as far as I'm concerned. If it's early, that means you'll get a better, richer, fresher garden. As you can see, that's where I stopped. That's as far as zoomed out as it'll go. Let me, this is a viewfinder with the sun. See, whenever I'm looking, the sun is like right in my eyes, generally. I don't remember where I go. Next one possible to get a good view of this. So right there. Okay, it's 2:31 p.m. I just dug up a little bit more right here. The way they see, this is the way people used to have to do it when there was no gas powered tillers or any of that stuff. With a basically a hoe. This right here is even something they didn't have. Not like this, not made out of metal. That's breaking up the ground a lot. I mean, if my wife will help me on the weekends, perhaps in the spring, about 3 or 4 weeks from now, because we're going to get cold. I know it's going to get under freezing, 20 degrees even. I mean, it is only February 5th. So after about the 28th of February or so, I can't see it getting a really frost. It might go down to 32 once or 31 one time, and that's it. It won't even freeze the ground hard. So, maybe by this weekend, if it's supposed to stay kind of warm in the 50s in the daytime and the upper 30s and low 40s at night, I'll come out here and I'll do this whole garden by hand with this bow rake. And then, like I say, if I get the chance to use a gas-powered tiller, that'd be great. But, you know, if I don't, you know what? Then what? What happens when you can't get gas no more? What are you going to do? Cry? You're going to do it by hand with your back in a bow rake or a hoe or something of that nature. So, this will be the first video for 2013 I'm doing on the garden. I got to blow this up a little bit. Make it easier to see. This way I can see in the viewfinder a little bit, even though the sun is right in my face. Okay, this is where my garden, you can see where it was last year. It would have been a really decent garden if all the crap hadn't happened, I don't think. But, you know, regardless, it was the first start over here after having started the other one at the yellow house that they bulldozed within a week of moving from it. So this one here, I would say by the second week of February, unless we have a really bad cold, is going to be turned if I have to do it all by hand. All right, everybody, stay safe. Try to get yourself a small garden, get you some basic vegetables in there. I wouldn't suggest corn. I just don't care for corn myself too much. And with the Monsanto crap, it's just difficult. Once they cross-contaminate an area, that's what I'm worried about with this yard here, if they spray any of the stuff in the fields. Look at the fields around me. Yeah, all was Monsanto corn. Of course, the drought killed all of it. But everything around this house, hundreds and hundreds of acres, was Monsanto corn. On the other side of the house over there, and that field over there was Monsanto corn. The field, all the way over there is a person going across the field walking their dog, I think. I can't really see it in the viewfinder, but I know it's a shit. She's out there in the orange or red top right there, I think. Walks her dog out there in the field. She lives in that big house. Where is that big house? No, I can't see it. That big house right there. So anyway, all I have was Monsanto corn, and I'm sure that's probably, I don't know if that's what they're planting, Monsanto corn, or if it'll be Monsanto soybeans or what, but the field out back goes about right at almost 4,000 feet back to the road back there, because I can't really fire my rifle back there. I mean, I could go for that tree right there, but it'd go further than that by about 500 to 1,000 feet. So from here where I'm at, I'm standing about 3,600 feet from that tree. So I really have no place really I can fire too much. It's got to be close range, like about 190 feet to 200 feet. But even there, I got to be careful where I've got my targets. So, need to get yourself a garden started, man. Even if you can only put up like two small rows, maybe put up about four tomato plants and four pepper plants, and I don't know what else you might want, but at least those two things are a good start. Beans if you can, I guess, okra. Everybody be safe, okay? Hopefully I'll have this one documented this season until like March when everything is planted. All right, everybody stay safe. It is February 5th, 2013 at 2:37 p.m. Central Time.